Okay, I'll start with introducing myself. So my name is Apeksha Kulkarni and I've been working with Advise now since past 5 years, and talking about Advise specifically. So we have been in this specifically industry like since now almost 29 years, started in 1991. Advise is one-stop solution for all your international study needs. We have been India's leading overseas education consultancy since 1991. We have a command on education opportunities worldwide. Our core activities lies in assisting students to make the right choice with regards to pursuing in overseas education. We work with many countries, starting with USA, Canada, UK, Ireland, New Zealand, Singapore, France, Germany, many more. So you can look forward for your nearest branch. We have 24 branch in and around India. So you can look forward for the nearest branch. You just have to register with us. You can check our website for more information and you can contact us. Moving towards our today's topic about computer science and IT in USA specifically. So while I talk about computer science majorly, but before that, why specifically in USA? So USA has an education system of older, like around 200 years now. The history of education, students have been studying in USA since very long time duration. We can definitely look forward for options available with the flexibility, the course choices, the majors and minors that students can study at both undergrad and postgrad level. Definitely, whether like specifically be it USA or any other country, USA has always been known for its top rank universities and ample of opportunities career wise as well as education wise. Whereas now, talking specifically about computer science and IT, we all have been looking right now, like working digitally, and lockdown definitely have given us and very much good perspective towards how digitally we need to be active and how much do we need the help of digital services. So whether your heart or mind are set on computer science and IT, you are still weighing your options. You know that its particular subject is big. So our lives are so digitally connected that there isn't one single industry where the skills of smart programmers can't be put to good use. And one of the most go study destination for international students looking to go undergrad students is computer science in the United States, along with IT. So basically, while we talk about computer science and IT, majority of students look forward for USA as the option. Reason why, I'll tell you, because there are excellent job opportunities. There are the education is accredited. Again, it has been recognized overall by all other countries also, not just by USA or by India. Okay, so while we talk about the computer science students, there are around 837 educational institutes approximately in USA which provides with computer science and IT related courses. Okay, there are around 766 courses which are related to IT and computer science. Approximately, this is what the figure says. But then if you explore more, there are ample of concentrations at bachelor's level and master's level if we talk about computer science and IT. Those are kind of, I'll give some examples of the concentrations that you can look into, like computer science into graphics, mathematics, algorithms, programming principles, artificial intelligence, cybersecurity, data science, health informatics, machine learning. So there are ample of options which you can keep looking forward for at your bachelor's and master's level, while we look forward for the options or specializing into bachelor's of IT or computer science. At IT also, there are different software options, engineering options, which you can look forward and take your steps accordingly. Generally, as for the bachelor's level, the requirements for a bachelor's of 4 years of education into computer science or IT, the requirements are very basic, that they require you to have 12 grade with at least minimum 60 to 65% along with a SATs requirement. So SATs is the requirement. So SAT requirement is exactly 150 plus at least out of 108. So while we talk about 1000 out of 1800, you need to score 1150 minimum with 12th grade of 60 to 65%. That is minimum what I'm talking about. The good, the better the SAT scores, the better the 12th grade scores, better universities you can target to. And major one very much important thing that USA doesn't just look at your academics or just look at your SAT, they look at your profile holistically. So if you have any instas, like any kind of internships or any kind of work done, any kind of publications or any kind of specific programs that you have taken while you're studying, like certification courses, that definitely help you out. Okay, so it is not just limited to your education or your SAT scores, but then definitely your SAT scores and your academic makes a very good difference while you apply. So having good scores helps. Whereas along with that, an IELTS or TOEFL is required for bachelors to apply forward for bachelors at the university levels. And this requirements is basic IELTS within 6.5 and NOVEN less than 6 out of 9 and TOEFL of 90 plus out of 120. Generally anything lower than that, around 79 or 80, is also accepted by many of the universities for undergrad level. Talking about masters, at master's level there are also different concentrations. So the masters which are provided are for 2 years. Your first year of Master's of Science or like computer science or IT goes for around 1 to 2 years of masters. Generally maximum time it goes with, the credits are divided accordingly based on your concentrations that you take. If you want to add up with any other majors, you have that flexibility of options to take in your bachelor's as well as your grad level. So both options definitely would be available with you guys. And talking about the requirements, so bachelor's, the master's requirement is a bachelor's into relevant field would be much better, but then with a 60 to 65%, but then again a student with a good work experience into the similar field or relevant field can also apply to computer science at master's or at IT. Okay, and not just limiting yourself for computer science or IT, you can apply to any other relevant coursework where it is related to. It is not just that the master's would be computer science. There are different options with different concentrations that you can take. Okay, and along with that, GRE is another requirement which is required for master's. About cons, verbal and analytical writing analysis. So you need to score a 300 plus out of 340. But again, for fall 2021, currently many of the universities have waived off the GRE requirement. Some still require it, but some have waived it off. So definitely we can help you out looking forward for those universities which you can apply. And still, yes, 100% there are chances that you can apply for fall 2021 if you have your documentations and things ready with you, or we can help you out how to get those faster and how can we start with your processing of applications. There are few universities which still have their deadlines or extended their deadlines due to the pandemic. So we have these options ongoing right now. We can definitely apply to colleges or the universities at USA for master's or undergrad level. We can explore more options which you can look forward for. The next available intake after September is Jan 2022. Okay, coming to the major point that we were talking about masters. So for masters, as I said, the requirement is a bachelor's with 60 to 65% minimum, and GRE of a 300 plus out of 340 is considered as good score. So anything nearby to it, we can definitely look forward for good opportunity, like good universities which you can go ahead with. And along with that, IELTS or TOEFL is required. So IELTS or TOEFL, similarly, the requirement is a 6.5 band out of 9, no band less than 6, and TOEFL within 90 plus out of 120. These are the minimum requirements. And talking about computer science or IT specifically again. So there are ample of varieties of specialization students selects. Along with that, what kind of states or what kind of universities you can look into, definitely that's why we are here to help you out. There are ample of like top rank universities from like universities like MIT, Harvard, or California regions universities, or the hubs which provides with, as we say, Silicon Valley is in USA. So there are ample of companies also, which after you grad, like if you complete your degree, like your bachelor's or your master's, there are ample and ample of opportunities in USA, because the headquarters of all known companies like Apple, Facebook, Microsoft, Google, and many other companies are based in USA. So there are definitely good opportunities, and along with that, there are definitely different opportunities, not just within USA, but also the computer science or IT students studying in, after studying in USA, have great opportunities outside of USA also. To be one with one more specific detail which I would like to provide over here, that after completion of your bachelor's or your master's, so bachelor's of 4 years and master's of 2 years, a student is eligible for 1 year, like 1 year of optional practical training durations and 24 months of STEM duration after, like STEM extension after your course. So in and around, student gets a stay back of 3 years if you go under a STEM course. STEM basically means the course which comes under science, technology, engineering, or math. Students, I see there are a few questions coming in. By end of the session, we can have around, and then I can answer your queries by that time. Okay, so moving towards the locations, the highest number of computer science or IT students getting cleared from are kind of from Los Angeles, New York, California, then Chicago, Fairfield, Iowa, or else you can look forward for this to like the graduates coming out from New Jersey. So there are ample of cities which provides with ample of university opportunities as well as the job opportunities. So students, you have enough time right now also to look forward for fall 2021 intake. Okay, and just to update with one thing, the students who are interested to go ahead, there are different types of universities and fairs which we are conducting at Advice. So we have a fair on 1st of March, that is on Monday, between 3 to 6 at where universities like, you know, California State University, San Bernardino, Kent State University, New York Institute of Technology, Pace University, Troy University, St. Leo University, this all 6-7 universities would be present on that same particular day, where you can meet those university delegates directly. You can have a word. This meetings have been conducted on Zoom, so if you are really interested, you can either reach to us through Instagram, Facebook, you can reach out at our office numbers where you can call and register yourself, so that we would be able to provide you with the meeting links on time, and you can directly speak with the delegate and get your questions answered. So if you have any queries like what are the requirements, whether you can apply right now, do you need to give GRE, or you are waiting for your mark sheets to come in because of the pandemic, still we can apply right now and wait for your final mark sheets to come in, so that you have at least an admission seat. By that time your mark sheet comes in, we can provide those to the universities and start with your other procedures. Okay. And now looking forward for the questions that we have, I think I have 2-3 questions. I'll just like to answer those first. So, ma'am, please suggest something for Matapasila. Students who are looking forward for some other courses like computer science or except computer science or IT, definitely you can reach us out on our office numbers, or else you can just drop us a message on Instagram or Facebook, so that we can put you in touch with the correct counselors, and for whichever country you're looking up to go ahead with, we can provide with the same. Okay. Hello, the gap acceptance after bachelor's degree. So how many years of gap do you hold? Okay, so one of the student has a query stating that how many years of gap acceptance after bachelor's degree is accepted. So there is always after a bachelor's degree, if a student has an relevant work experience, it always helps. But then what was the reason of that gap will make a lot of difference while you apply. But then definitely by studying, if you have done some kind of certification courses or you have been doing an internship or working, that definitely gives a plus point to your profile. Okay, if doing bachelor's from USA, then also IELTS needed in master's again with GRE. So that purely depends upon the university where you're applying forward for. But then yes, it is suggested that you apply for an with GRE to ma for master's degree and with IELTS also, because visa requirements are also there that you require an IELTS. But then if the university is waiving off your GRE or your IELTS requirement, you can state the same in your visa interview and get it cleared. I hope Shetu Shah have cleared your query. Okay, so Rahul, I'm not the correct person to answer for your New Zealand queries, but then definitely if you can just ping us or message us on Instagram or Facebook or provide us with your number, we can help ask the New Zealand counselor to get back with your queries, whatever like related to PR after studies and the education, whatever is the current situation about the same. Any other queries? Okay, just to update again that we have a fair on 1st of March with for USA specifically related to computer science and IT. Do make sure that you attend it. It's between 3 to 6. Students can understand what are the requirements, what are the current options available for them, which would be the nearest intake for them, what are the tuition fees, and directly you can speak about the same with the delegates. In case of any other queries, also you can attend that fair where we have our counselors, we have our team who can guide you through the procedures. Okay, do register with us, do give us a call if you need any kind of guidance. I hope this was helpful for you guys. Thank you so much. Yes, we do provide counseling, career counseling sessions, except like for any other kind of courses also. It's not just related to computer science or IT. We help with all courses, including law, engineering, medical, be it arts or anything relevant to management field. So we work with all fields in all countries. So if any student who's looking apart from computer streams or IT streams, definitely just reach us out and we would be able to guide you through like what options are available, which universities you can look into. Okay. Yes, Khan Nazim. Yeah, the gap is accepted if you have a work experience. So generally after bachelor's, like if you're planning to go forward for master's, there are different options depending upon your profile. We would be able to guide you because every university, every course that you're looking up for has different requirements. So with good work experience, you can look forward for good courses at management, engineering level, or else related to the computer science or IT course also. So what is your bachelor's into? What is your profile into? Definitely the counselor would go through it, have a study at your profile, and we would be able to help you out with the same. Okay. I hope, Kanazin, I've answered your question. In case of any queries, guys, please do reach us back and we would be able to help you out through. Thank you. Thank you so much.